Hello YouTube, this is Lewis and Friends, aka MK5, aka Lewis JM. I'm back here at Jersey City where I'm going to do an update on the Barcade. Now, I've been here before a long time back and I've never gone here back for reasons. But considering now I have a job as right now, I can actually go down here whenever I want. So, today I'm just going to show you all the arcade games, what they got, see what's good around here, and give you my recommendations. So, why don't we begin? Start off, we have Sega's Crazy Taxi. Then over here we have the Street Fighter 2 Super Turbo. Always, I swear, these names get weirder and weirder every now and then. Then we got Midway's Ms. Pac-Man. Sega's Ultra Beast. Atari's Crystal Castle. Then we got Bubble Bubble from Romstar. Then we have another one from Romstar known as Snow Bros, which is mostly you push snow and then you take out enemies. A bit of a weird game, but definitely has its uniqueness to it. Then over here we have the Universal's Mr. Do, which is mostly, I think, Dig Dug in a way. Joust. Frogger. And then we got a Neo Geo cabinet that has like a 4 selection game. These include Windjammers, Metal Slug. We got Neo Geo Cup 98 and Puzzle Bubble. Then over here we have the Dragon Spirit. Going downstairs we have like another collection of games right here. Of course they got, you can't have an arcade without the classic Star Wars Trilogy arcade. And then we got this unique game. It's a Tetris, but involving Disney characters known as Magical Tetris Challenge. That is somewhat of a bizarre thing, but I guess I can understand that Tetris needs to get on the whole Disney bandwagon and all that. Why do you never see that in Disney World of all places, or Disneyland? And of course we got Monkey Ball from Sega. It's sponsored by Dole, apparently. How about that? Of course, they got the 4-player versus of Pac-Man. And over here, they got the Daytona USA, but one of the screens isn't working at this moment, so it's understandable. And of course, Konami's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the classic original version. Of course, they have pinballs as well, so we got here the Black Hole Pinball Machine. And then we got the Vector, which is mostly like Rollerball in a way. The Adventures of Rocky Bullwinkle and Friends. And of course, we have Earthquake. There'll be more pinball machines later on, so stay tuned. Then we have got the Play Choice 10 from Nintendo, which has a variety of games. When I checked last time, it was Mega Man 3, which I knew what the other games are, but hey, it's hard to tell. I guess we can wait now and see. And of course, we got Super Punch-Out, which is like the original Punch-Out, having the double screens. Okay, here we go. We got Legend of Zelda, Tyson's Punch-Out, Double Dragon, Friday the 13th, Rainbow Islands, Contra, Mega Man 3, Dr. Mario, Gauntlet, and Super Mario Bros. 2. Strange they don't have the original Mario Bros., but I guess they got the right collection. Probably they have a Friday the 13th, though. Then, of course, we got Burger Time, which has this Japanese-like design. I remember that that it's much more Americanized in certain areas, but I guess it is what it is. Then we have Atari's Millipede. then we got the R-Type. Now this one, I'm kind of surprised. They got an actual Golly Ghost, which is mostly a shoot 'em up, but as you can see, they got like, interesting backdrop, which is most real life, and it does have its charm to it. I've seen this before in the sports world back in Paris when it was in Route 17 before they closed down. And I'm amazed that they got quite a collection, quite the game right here. Oh, it is amazing how they handle such things. And then continuing on, we got NBA Jam. And we got this interesting Japanese game that I never heard of. It's called the Bishi Bashi, which is kind of weird. It's mostly like, you hit as many buttons as you can, but within a lot of time, just for the challenge. I have no idea what this is about, but definitely does its charm to it. We got Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. Then we got the Ocean Hunter from Sega. I remember seeing these games before they move on to more evolved shoot 'em ups. That's mostly underwater with sharks, with the aquatic life trying to kill ya. Then we got Gunblade Special Air Assault Force New York. It's kind of funny because I'm living near New York City, so that's quite a unique way of trying to promote it. Of course, we got the Tapper with the Budweiser logo in it. Always have two versions, one with root beer, one with Bud. Then we have Jumbo Safari. Like, sort of like a racing, capturing animal type of deal. Now we get to the most obscure one, Chicken Shift. How this works is basically you have to maneuver the eggs into the proper places. I've played this a little before, but I find it kind of weird, especially when they have like the type of extreme mechanics. Still, it does have its charm, even if it is kind of baffling in some sort of form or fashion. And of course we got Fire Truck, which is like an instant classic from Atari. Just race it down and hope to just race it down a ramp and try not to get spilled over. And of course we got the Gauntlet Dark Legacy. Classic Galaga by Midway. Nintendo Stunt Con. And another instant classic in Asteroids. And I'll separate it off with some pinball machines right here. We got Dialed In from Jersey Jack, like the LDDT. And then we have the Funhouse. Taxi, where you have to pick up as many people, including Dracula and Santa Claus, which is kind of funny because, you know, Christmas season. It has all of these deep shoes, which is kind of amazing. And of course, we got John Carpenter's Halloween. We got the Rush Pinball Machine. Star Trek The Next Generation. Congo. And finally, we have Godzilla. Most of them have digital screens, the other have like the LED screens, which always an interesting one. And that's with the tour. I gotta admit, this is quite the collection, and believe it or not, have something for everyone. Shoot 'em ups, beat 'em ups, platformers, pinball, almost everything and everything. Good recommendation if you guys are wanting to visit Jersey City. So, that'll do it for the tour. Hope you guys enjoy it. Stay tuned for more, and I'll see you all next time. #GrowTheGoodCartoons.